Otherwise, I agree with your policy that Muslims should support Muslims. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Yes, brother. This question was asked by the professor. What is the Islamic perspective on Darwin's theory of evolution? What is our stand, basically, on that?
The brother asked the question that what is the Islamic stance on Darwin's theory? On Darwin's theory of evolution, that human beings have been created from ape. Brother, if you read the book of Origin of Species, Darwin traveled on a ship named as HMS Beagle and went to an island by the name of Calatropis. And there he saw birds, the finches, they pecked at holes. Depending upon the niche, the hole they pecked, the beak kept on becoming small and big. Based on this knowledge, Darwin said that I believe in the theory of evolution that one species can transform to the other. But he had no proof for that. In fact, he wrote a letter to his friend Thomas Thornton in the year 1861 that I don't believe in the theory of evolution because I've got proof, but because it helps me in classification of embryology, morphology, rudimentary organs. He had no proof for that. But unfortunately today, it is taught in the school as a fact. It's not a fact, it's a theory. Darwin's theory is just a hypothesis. There's no proof for that at all. I know there are vestiges, there are some fossils, that from that we can say that, okay, this, we have been evolved from ape. According to P.P. Grasse, in the year 1971, he held the chair of the evolutionary studies. In Paris, he said that we cannot decipher who were our ancestors just based on few vestiges. Vestiges mean fossils. And we know today there are four waves. If you know about the hominoids, there are four waves of hominoids. The first is Lucy. The first is Lucy Australopithecus, which came about 3.5 million years ago and died by the Ice Age. The second wave was the Homo erectus, which died about 500,000 to 150,000 years ago. Third was the Neanderthal man, which died about 40,000 years ago. And last was the Cro-Magnon. See, the Quran says in Surah Nuh, chapter 71, verse number 14, that the human beings have been created in stages. But there is no proof that one hominoid has been transformed to the other. And there is no proof showing that we have been transformed from the human being. No proof at all. Where it comes to, do you believe in Darwin's theory? Some people say it's totally wrong. Some people say it's totally right. We Muslims are in between. Today, there is some proof on one species changing to another in the lower level, like amoeba. Nowhere does the Quran say that amoeba cannot transform into another species. But there's no proof at all at a higher level, at the animal level or at the level of the human beings. There's no proof at all. It's a hypothesis. But unfortunately, this hypothesis is taught in the schools and universities as a fact. No wonder we say that if we have to insult someone, we say that if you were present at Darwin's time, Darwin's theory would have been proved right. Trying to insinuate he looks like an ape. There's no proof at all. There are missing links which Darwin himself said. It's just an assumption. So Alhamdulillah, Quran does not agree that we have been evolved from ape. The first set of human beings that came on the world was Adam and Eve, peace be upon them. There are researches being done to prove that. And some scientists said that, yes, agree, we have come from one pair. But yet, it hasn't been testified yet. It's just under research. So Darwin's theory is an outdated theory. No scholar believes in it today. Only those who don't have up-to-date knowledge will say it is right. It's an assumption. Maybe it may be true, but it's not a fact at all. So we don't have to test Quran with assumptions. If anyone wants to test the Quran is right or wrong, ask him to get any scientific fact, and there's not a single verse of the Holy Quran which goes against scientific facts. Hope that answers the question.
Yes.